Hi, welcome to our Pharma Topics channel. Our topic of discussion is a very important topic, determination of the potency of the antagonist by measuring the PA2 values. Here the method employed is shield plot method. Here we are given with a data of dose of vinylephrine, which is the agonist, and with the DRC is taken without the blocker prazosin and with different concentrations of the blocker. So let us plot the PA2 values. So we are given with the dose and the response. So let us convert the dose first into log dose. So equal to log, to convert all the dose of the vinylephrine to log doses. So we will convert all the doses to log doses. Then we will convert the responses to percentage response. That is the every response divided by maximum response, which is here is 49. So we will convert all the responses to percentage response. So let us see the percentage response in the presence of 0.004 micrograms per ml of prazosin. So here also the height of the response is not changing because it is a competitive blocker. So let us, when the concentration of the prazosin increases, let us see the percentage response. Here also the height of the response doesn't increase beyond 40. If the height decreases, then it is a non-competitive blocker. So let us see the percentage response in the presence of 0.0016 microgram per ml of prazosin. Different concentrations. The next step is plotting log DRC of vinylephrine. I have already plotted the log DRC of vinylephrine in the presence of different concentrations of prazosin and without prazosin. So here you have to interpolate at 50% and you have to find out the ED50 values. So I have calculated here ED50 value in the absence of prazosin, it is 0.2059 micrograms per ml, whereas it increases when the concentration of the prazosin increases. So let us see how to plot the PA2 value. So you have to, with the different concentrations, you have to find the ED50 values. So then you have to plot different concentrations is 0.004 micrograms, 0.008 micrograms, 0.016 micrograms of prazosin. So for to convert the mole to micromole, microgram to micromole, you have to divide by molecular weight. So you will get this value. The molecular weight of prazosin given is 419.9. So next, convert micromole to molar equal to, so this divided by the volume of the argon bath is 10, so divided by 1000 divided by 10 is 10,000. So you will get this value applied to all the other things. So convert the molar to log molar concentration. So you will get this value. You apply to this molar to log molar. So we have already calculated the ED50 values. So the dose ratio is the ratio without the prazosin and with the prazosin. So that is the dose with prazosin TD50 value divided by dose without prazosin. So equal to dose of prazosin TD50 value divided by without prazosin, what is the TD50 value. So here the dose of the prazosin TD50 value divided by without the prazosin. So dose ratio minus 1 equal to minus 1. This value apply then you convert that to log. So this number to the base 10. Then convert that. The last step is plotting the log molar concentration of prazosin and the log TR minus 1. You will get the PA2 value. You go for insert, scatter, plot this. So this is the PA2 value. Here it is intersecting at 8.79 or 8.78 you can put as. So here you insert. So this intersection value you get the PA2 value equal to 8.7. The values you can express in the positive value. This is the PA2 value of prazosin. So wherever it is intersecting, you have to plot it. So let us see another example. You are given the same data like this. It is just to convert that to log dose response curves. We apply this. So convert. Here the blocker is atropine and the agonist is acetylcholine equal to log. So this value to the base 10. So apply this to all. So here the maximum value is 48. So this divided by 48. This value, I mean the concentration of the atropine, is the same concentration is followed here also, as like prazosin we have seen before, divided by 48. Height decreases, but the maximum height does not decrease. So equal to its height divided by 48. In the presence of 0.016 micrograms per ml of atropine, let us see the percentage response equal to this value divided by 48. So let us plot this. If you plot it graphically, you get the log DRC of DRC of first input. the axis is the log concentration. So this is the percentage response. So you can see the DRC shifts to the right. So at the 50%, you have to see the ED50 values. So you can see the ED50 values. So if you interpolate, I have already calculated. Let us take this. So this is acetyl cooling. So here the value I have already calculated, it was found to be 0.181 microgram per ml. In the presence of 0.004 micrograms, it was found to be 0.3003, and in the presence of 0.008 micrograms per ml of atropine, it was found to be 0.4673, and in the presence of 0.016 micrograms of atropine, it was found to be 0.627. So we will apply this to our previous formulas. So concentration 0.004 micrograms, 0.008, 0.016. This is for acetyl cooling. Take the same example. This is for atropine. So we will apply similarly for divide the microgram per ml to micromolar per ml. So apply that to all things, then convert to micromolar to molar, this divided by 1000. The volume of the argon bath is 10. So we apply that. Then you convert that to log molar concentration. So log this number to the base 10. Apply this to all the things. So let us calculate the ED50 value. I have already mentioned in the previous slide also, 0.181, 0.303, 0.4673, 0.6217. So dose response, dose ratio is this value divided by the dose without the blocker. So this divided by dose without the blocker equal to this value divided by the dose without the blocker. So I have minus 1 from this value. We apply that to all the other things. This you take the log. It is 10. Okay. These rows are not needed. So let us plot log molar concentration versus log dr minus 1. So this is the pA2 value of acetyl atropine. Is the pA2 value of atropine. So it intersects around 8.85 or 8.88 is the pA2 value. Equal to 8.87 is the pA2 value of atropine. So this is the method which you have to apply for. So you have to take the log DRC, then you have to find the ED50 value, second step. Third value is you have to find the log molar concentration of atropine or the blocker. Then you have to find the dose ratio minus 1. Then you have to plot log DR minus 1 versus the log molar concentration of the blocker. So you will where the it intersects, that is the pA2 value. I hope it will be useful for you how to find the pA2 value. Thank you for listening. Happy learning. Kindly share this to your friends. Kindly subscribe to our Pharma Topics channel for further updates. Thank you.